party time! I want to hear about some Digimon. Did you know Digimon World had a sequel? No, not that one. Not that one. Definitely not that one. Yeah, that one. It's Digimon World Next Order. Released 17 years after the first Digimon World, Digimon World Next Order serves as a sequel that also tries to improve upon the gameplay of the original. They remix some of the music from the first game, such as... They added way more Digimon to recruit, and most importantly, they made the grind even harder to deal with. And it's overcoming that steeper level of grind, which is what we'll be talking about today. Let's do some quick math. In Digimon World Next Order, the stat caps for your partners are increased from 9,999 for HP and MP, and 999 for everything else, to 99,999 and 9,999 for everything else. But the initial gains from training only increased from approximately 88,87,777 to 110,110,12,12,12,12,12. What does this mean? What do these numbers mean? This means way more training is required for you to stay competitive in a game that throws way tougher enemies at you, far quicker than they did in the original game. And on top of all that, you have to do so while juggling two Digimon at the same time. So today, I'm going to show you what I found to be the easiest way to start maxing stats as soon as possible. And while we won't be able to get it fully working till Chapter 2, we can start setting it up in Chapter 1 and still get some benefits from it in the meantime. So the first thing we need to do is obtain the fishing rod. This is easy enough, as all it requires is recruiting Wormmon. Head to the forest path to talk to Wormmon, who will ask you to find a strong branch to use it in creating a fishing rod. The strong branch can be found further down the forest path. Once you bring it back to them, they join the city and you now have the fishing rod. Good start. Now that we have the fishing rod, we'll head back to Nye Plains and fish till we have a Digifry, a Digicrucian, and a Digicoy. Once you have one of each, we will head towards Mod Cape to recruit Seedramon. You can find Seedramon on Mod Ship 1.0, where they will require the three fish you have caught in Nye Plains. Once you hand them over, Seedramon will give you a feather lure, which will be important later, and then head to the city to open up the fishing spot. Fantastic, things are happening. Next, you're going to want to start dumping your Tamer points into the specific Tamer skills. Under the Survivor skill group, we'll want to get the Wild Finder, Fisherman, Wild Scouter, Grander, and finally Ingredient Hunter. This means that when you are fishing, it's at max capacity. If you're really grinding out Tamer points and have even more to spare, then pour a little into the Extractor abilities, because that will make later steps even easier. Regardless of whether you've upgraded your material mining abilities, we are now going to start gathering material. Next, we're going to use those materials to upgrade the fishing hole to level 3 via the builders. This is going to require 70 Digi Deep Water, 20 Digi Sands, 10 Digi Palms to upgrade to level 2, and then 70 Digi Ion Water, 20 Digi Stone, 10 Digi Snow Wood to upgrade to fishing hole level 3. Now that you have the third fishing hole open and you've got max fishing stats, you can start earning some super easy money. Every day during the evening and night cycle, which is about 1600 o'clock to 2 o'clock, be sure to use the feather lure on fishing hole 3 to catch as many fish as possible. If you want to push past your Digimon's bedtime, you can do so. Keep them awake, they'll eventually go to sleep on their own. This is totally worth it. We're not sleeping, we're earning money. Almost all of the fish in fishing hole 3 at this time of day is worth huge money. The best one being Digi Arowana and the Digi Piruchu. I know I mispronounced it. What are you going to do? Both sell for about 2,000 bits apiece. Now that you are beginning to earn some solid money from this fishing, you're able to now afford as many items as you want. You're able to buy the nice food at the restaurant for the stat boosts. We can start doing some stuff. We're already... forward momentum is happening. What we're going to want to do is we're going to want to head back to Mod Cape and talk to Demi Devimon in the ship 2.0 cabin. There, they will ask you to get Vikemon's treasure for them, which will require heading up to the captain's cabin and defeating Vikemon in battle. It's up to you if you want to head back to recruit Devi Devimon after the battle or not. Just right now, we need Vikemon. After defeating Vikemon, he will hang out at the fishing hole and will offer to upgrade your fishing rod if you complete his challenge. All you need to do to beat his challenge is collect 5 black trout without leaving the fishing area, which is pretty easy with your max fishing stats. The final thing to do in Chapter 1 is to upgrade the sender to level 2, as this will allow us to recruit Wizardmon in the next chapter, which will require 20 Digicopper, 30 Digiwhitewood, and 10 Digipalm. You've now completed everything you can do in Chapter 1. This extra money is going to allow you to have the stats and items you need to get through the rest of Chapter 1. Once Chapter 1 is completed, you can finish setting up this beautiful system. Now it's time to drag our Digi-ass over to the Bony Resort via the Aguino Wastelands. When we get there, we'll need to track down Wizardmon and begin their quests. This requires backtracking to Rosemon's palace entrance and talking to Garurumon. When we are done talking to Garurumon, we will need to backtrack one more time to Wizardmon to get him to join the city. Having Wizardmon in the city is going to allow us to set this whole thing up way quicker than we would if we were just following the storyline. When Wizardmon joins the city, they will hang out with the senders, and they offer you a chance to be sent somewhere random for free via magic. What we need to do is wait till a Thursday in which Wizardmon will send us to Absolute Zero. Make sure to bring an autopilot. Once there, you'll want to head north to the exterior of the Frost Cathedral and find Ikakumon to start their quest. They require you to travel to Dead End Town in the Server Desert and talk to Seraphimon. Once you've talked to Seraphimon, they will join the city. And once again, it's up to you if you want to talk to Kakumon or recruit them as well. Seraphimon is the final important piece of this puzzle. Now that all the pieces are in place, continue fishing every day between 16 and 2 o'clock while spending the rest of the day doing whatever you want. Just be sure that the 2 times a day your Digimon get hungry are spent going to Seraphimon for his dishes at the restaurant, because they offer some of the best stat boosts in the game. You will also have plenty of money to spend on any items you may need or want. As long as you spend your TP wisely by unlocking trainer abilities that extend the life of your Digimon and increase the stats, you should never truly be buried in grind ever again. And there you go. It was a lot of work to set up, but let's show some math just to see what we actually accomplished with all this. So with this method, your Digimon eat 2 times a day, and they'll eat about 2 to 3 times per meal, depending on the Digimon. So we'll say on average 5 foods they eat a day. If you take Seraphimon's Paradise Fruit Basket, which was my go-to, which is 500, 500, 50, 50, 50, 50 for your stats, that means that total stats from just one day of just eating, no training, no nothing, is 2,500, 2,500, 250, 250, 250, 250. Now, as far as just the regular just using the gym to train your guys strategy goes, with each gain, you get about a 110, 110, 12, 12, 12, 12. You can train about 13 times a day. So that's only going to equal your stats at about 1430 for HP and MP and 156 for everything else. And that's only one stat at a time. That's not a group of stats. Now, keep in mind, there are, of course, things you can do to boost the vanilla gym method, such as spending money to upgrade equipment, using training, boosting foods, tamer abilities, etc. But, I mean, you could also do that while doing the fishing method, you know? No matter how you decide to proceed through the game, I wish you the best of luck with your adventure. I thank you for watching. Hope you have a good one. Later now.